This is Generation Stadia, giving you that daily dose of everything and anything Stadia related, and today we have quite a bit of news to cover. In this video, we'll be discussing Google's response to the 4K 60fps issue, buddy passes being out, December's pro games, and so much more. But before going into all of that, let's quickly dive into some video game updates. If you recently purchased Grid and are excited about the Season 1 content drop, well, the wait on Stadia is gonna be just a bit longer. According to the official Grid Twitter page, post-launch content will be coming to Stadia, but at a later date. Once the date gets known, they're gonna let us know, but as of right now, there's still no estimated time for the Season 1 content drop. Next on the list of game updates that you need to know about comes from Farming Simulator 2019. So in case you're out of the loop, Farming Simulator 2019 Platinum Edition will be a Stadia Pro game for December. But we'll talk more about that later. What's important to say right now is that the developer went on Reddit to explain that Farming Simulator supports crossplay support between PC and Stadia. On top of that, it happens to be one of the few games actually running in 4K resolution at 60fps. And if that's not enough to entice you, it's also running at max settings. It's always great to see a confirmation of a Stadia game fulfilling that 4K 60fps promise, and I'd be lying if I told you that I wasn't a bit more interested in the game simply because of that. Now the last bit of gaming news I have for you today comes via a brand new title announced for Stadia. The indie game Spitlings, developed by Massive Mini Team, is coming to Google Stadia. The game promises to be a hardcore scream at your friends cooperative experience, with the goal of the game being to clear each level of all bubbles by popping them with your spit. Now that may sound easy enough, but if one player fails, everyone has to start over. The game has over 100 plus levels with story mode and cutscene animations. Now I know this isn't a big AAA title like some of you may be wanting, but having indie support for Google Stadia is a very positive thing. Also, I've played the arcade game that I believe this is based off of, and that's Buster Bros, and let me tell you, that game is super challenging but also very fun. Anyways, that concludes all the game updates, so let's move on to the regular Stadia news. So up first, let's discuss the fact that Stadia Buddy Passes are now out, and all you have to do to access it is open up your Stadia app and check that envelope in the top left corner. The Stadia Buddy Pass code will be sent to your Stadia account email so you can give that code to whoever you'd like. It's good to see that these codes have been given out simply because it'll start populating servers for more games at a faster rate. Specifically, Destiny 2. I actually haven't had very long queue times when looking for a match anymore, and I'm starting to see more players with numbers attached to their name. Moving on from this, let's talk about the PR update Google is doing to try and communicate with the community better. So at the beginning of this week, it was announced that Google will be doing community updates daily throughout the week. They did say that this was experimental to see how it goes, but I really do believe they should keep going with this. We certainly don't hear enough from Google, and I think the community has made that pretty loud and clear this past week, but it's good to see them taking a step in the right direction. Building this early line of communication with consumers, but more important, the early adopters, is a very good thing to see. Even more important is that they're reacting on this so quickly, so it does seem that they're taking these issues seriously. It is important to note that there won't be any updates on November 28th and 29th due to Thanksgiving in the United States. Moving on from that, let's talk about the two Stadia Pro games that are coming for December. As you heard earlier in this video, Farming Simulator 2019 Platinum Edition is coming, along with Tomb Raider Definitive Edition. Now before you raise your pitchforks because you bought these games just last week, Google has stated that they will be refunding those purchases if requested. And yes, they will be refunded even if you've played for more than the 2 hours the policy allows. It was also stated that both Destiny 2 The Collection and Samurai Showdown will be able to get claimed throughout December as well. Overall, I'm pretty happy with what's been announced here. Yeah, I can see some people being slightly disappointed, but Farming Simulator is a game I've always wanted to try, but never really could justify buying. As for Tomb Raider, I've actually played through it before, so I doubt I'll be going through it again other than for testing purposes, but I'm not gonna complain here simply because they did only promise us one game a month, so anything more than that is just icing on the cake. Now the last thing I want to talk about in this video is Stadia addressing the 4K 60fps problem. Now, in case you don't know, not many games are actually running at native 4K resolution, 60 frames per second. Despite the expectations we had or what we were told, this is certainly an issue and I'll be addressing it in its own separate video soon. But for right now, Google did address this issue and concern, and here's what they said. Stadia streams at 4K and 60fps, and that includes all aspects of our graphics pipeline from game to screen. GPU, encoder, and Chromecast Ultra all outputting at 4K to 4K TVs with the appropriate internet connection. Developers making Stadia games work hard to deliver the best streaming experience for every game. Like you see on all platforms, this includes a variety of techniques to achieve the best overall quality. We give developers the freedom of how to achieve the best image quality and frame rate on Stadia, and we are impressed with what they've been able to achieve for day one. We expect that many developers can, and in most cases will, continue to improve their games on Stadia. And because Stadia lives in our data centers, developers are able to innovate quickly while delivering even better experiences directly to you without the need for game patches or downloads. Now, this overall statement is fine and they address the concern, but I do feel a bit conflicted on how to take it. This really does make it sound like it's a developer side issue on making these games run 4K 60fps, but I'm not so sure that's the case. At least, not all of it. Now, we know that the server blades are running on a Vega 56 GPU, but we also happen to know the limitations of that card. For example, it could run Destiny 2 at 1440p on max settings, but running 4K resolution 60fps max settings just isn't feasible. Now, that being said, why is it 1080p medium settings? Well, if I had to place a bet right this moment, I would put it on Vulkan. Now, if you want to find out why, I'll put a link in the description below to a Reddit post that really breaks down the reasoning. The good news is that Vulkan support will get better over time, but I do have to admit, Google also messed up on the marketing here. They really did tout that 4K 60fps number before launch, and it set people's expectations as such. Anyways, that wraps up today's news video. If you enjoyed it or found it helpful at all, be sure to hit that like button as it really does help the channel out. And if you're wanting more content like this, be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell as well. Today's end of video message is going to be a quick question. How do you feel about the game updates at the start of this video? Do you like them being mixed in with the general Stadia news, or would you prefer them to be in their own separate video, but more in detail and in depth? For example, if I was doing it in its own separate video, I would be going into detail of what the Season 1 content drop for Grid is. Do let me know what you think in the comment section below. Anyways, this has been Generation Stadia, giving you that daily dose of everything and anything Stadia related. The Gen S community is over 1,600 strong and growing by the day, and until next time, I'll catch you in the clouds.